Alright, y'all, welcome to Loyalty
One.
Yeah, that's our new name. So there's a story behind it, but right now it's not too much of the time to get into it. We'll get to it later. This is just a straight song that we reacted to by my boy J. Cole. I believe the track is called Snow on the Bluff. When I called this guy up to say, all right, let's go ahead and listen to the song, already social media has been blowing up about it, talking about, you know, X, Y, and Z and who he might be coming at. And we saw, you know, some of the stuff going on. So now we're going to go ahead and check this out, see what he really said. And then hopefully, you know, that'll connect the dots together more of everything that's going on. Him and I are big J. Cole fans, so I'm pretty sure he's not really going to upset us with some of the things he said, but that's enough for that. Let's just get right to this video. Well, audio.
Niggas be thinking I'm deep, intelligent, fooled by my college degree. My IQ is average, there's a young lady out there, she way smarter than me. I scroll through her timeline in these wild times and I started to read. She mad at these crackers, she mad at these capitalists, mad at these murder police. She mad at my niggas, she mad at her ignorance, she wear her heart on the sleeve. She mad at the celebrities, low key I be thinking she talking about me. Now I ain't no dummy to think I'm above criticism, so when I see something that's valid, I listen. But shit, it's something about the queen's home that's bothering me. She strike me as somebody blessed enough to grow up in conscious environment with parents that know about the struggle for liberation. And in turn they provide her with a perspective and awareness of the system and the fairness that afflicts them and the clearest understanding of what we gotta do to get free. And the frustration that feels the worst seems to come from the fact that most people don't see. Just cause you woke and I'm not, that shit ain't no reason to talk like you better than me. How you
Woo! Woo! Man, I'm trying to keep up.
But he do have a point.
Yeah, he do, but he woo! Alright, let's just keep going. But I'm picking this up.
When you attacking the very same niggas that really do need the shit that you saying, instead of conveying you holier, come help us get her to speed. Shit, it's a reason it took like 200 years for our ancestors just to get free. These shackles be locking the mental way more than the physical. I look at freedom like trees, can't grow for us like overnight. Hit the ghetto and slowly start planting your seeds. Fuck is the point of you preaching your message to those that already believe what you believe. I'm also fucking retweet, most people is sheep. You got all the answers, but how you gonna reach? If I could make one more suggestion respectfully, I would say it's more effective to treat people like children, understanding the time and love and patience that's needed to grow. This change is inevitable, but ain't none of seen this before, therefore we just gotta learn everything as we go. I struggle with thoughts on the daily, feel like a slave to somehow to save, and no coins to buy his way up out of slavery. Think it just maybe in my pursuit to make life so much better for me and my babies. I'd have betrayed the very same people that look at me like I'm some kind of a hero because of the zeros that's next to the commas. But look here, I promise I'm not who you think. Ran into this nigga outside of the store yesterday, he said something that had me like wait. He was like, Cole, appreciate what you've been doing, my nigga, that's real, but damn, why I feel faker than snow on the bluff? Well, maybe because deep down I know I ain't doing enough.
I thought the beat was gonna be way harder. I feel like people call him misogynistic and this and that, but he was just talking. People be mad because he talking. I don't see what he went wrong with it. That is a true fact. If somebody's way woker than you,
like, you shouldn't criticize people. That it's a thing of he was saying, like, you know, just because I'm not educated like you are, don't criticize me for it. Help educate me. Like, help me walk through this process. It's like it. Because, you know, like, there's a reason why there's always a teacher. Like, you know, somebody can throw a book in our face, and then we can read the book and gain all that knowledge, but not fully understand it. Therefore, we need other people to help us understand it.
But the center of this shit is, are you really woke, or are you just bashing the black community? Are you really
bashing
woke?
The ones that look like they ain't
or are you just bashing us because you're smarter than us? I ain't hear anything he said that was wrong.
Like what he said. He said, if I could make one more suggestion respectfully, I would say it's more effective to treat people like children, understanding the time and the love and patience that's needed to grow. With what Notre Dame said in terms of people need to be educated, I agree with that on that. But then at the same time, I agree with Cole. It's like, it's the process. We can't get it just like that. It takes time for people to learn. Everybody learns differently.
What did she say?
Said, this was a tweet. Poor black folks all over the country are putting their bodies on the line in the protest of our collective safety. And y'all favorite top-selling rappers not even willing to put a tweet up. Niggas whole discographies be about black plight, and they're nowhere to be found. So, my thing is this about the tweet piece thing that irritates my soul a bit. It's the fact, like, another thing that I feel like when he tweeted out about this, what I read from his tweet about his track was that, you know, some people are meant to talk, some people are meant to put their words out on social media. Other guys are not meant to. Some of the guys are just meant to be after rappers, which is exactly what J. Cole was doing. He was out there doing that. Now, No Name may not be speaking about J. Cole specifically, but you know, she's talking about, you know, guys as a whole. A lot of people said that she was talking about Kendrick as well. Well, there are photos of Kendrick out there protesting as well. They don't have to put that on social media. And then another thing that kills me is that, you know, we talked about this when we was in the car. I said that those same people that criticize celebrities for not putting something out on social media be the same ones that'll criticize celebrities for putting stuff like that on social media, saying, oh, they're doing this for clout attention or whatever the case is, bro. Like, at the end of the day, they're doing the work. Action speaks louder than words at the end of the day. We still need the speakers. We still need those people to, you know, to talk. But, you know, if somebody is just, you know, doing just the work, you know, or, you know, putting in the effort and not really speaking much, there shouldn't be a problem with that. Because some people, those same people who are actually doing the right thing working, if they speak something and say something wrong, then nobody even gonna care about the work they did. They're just gonna slander them for the things they said. So some people are meant to just to keep their mouth shut. You know what I'm saying?
I think some people should keep their mouth shut, but they don't look past everything that they do. It's just like, people say crazy stuff, but they
I'm sorry.
Look away, Kayla.
People say stupid stuff all the time, but they still listen to their music. It's like, who just did something stupid? I'm trying to think. It was something that somebody said.
Well, Doja Cat said something stupid.
Doja Cat, that's a perfect example. But people still listen to her music.
She tried to come back, and people was like, why the fuck you back?
And it's like, people be like, I don't support her as a person, but her music is fire, so I'm just going to go ahead and listen to it. But I'm not going to listen to her as a person. I mean, it doesn't go ignored. It's just one of those things that happen.
I feel like her putting it on social media and... No, I'm talking about No Name and this and that. Are you reaching for attention too?
Is she protesting?
I don't know.
I haven't seen her. If that's it.
I mean, and my thing is this: to back on her comment about what she said about how they do make music about, you know, being pro black or whatever. Like, for instance, Kendrick Lamar, To Pimp a Butterfly. All of that was basically about that. You know, with All Right and all the rest of that stuff. Well, maybe you got to think that's their best way of communicating that. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes that's what the beauty about art forms, you know, rapping or, you know, people who paint a picture. There are different ways people, you know, communicate certain things. And, you know, speaking is not everybody's best trait. So, you know, there is a difference between rapping and speaking. So there is a difference. I don't care what nobody says. There is a difference.
I don't know. I feel like No Name is... It's not that we don't care about what she says and what she
does. Because she got points, bro. Both sides got points. I don't think there is a right or wrong in this. It's a matter of preference at this point. But I just don't think whatsoever you should criticize somebody who is not posting on social media and they're still going out. They're doing something at the end of the day.